Good evening and a warm welcome to this service of Choral Evensong, whether you're joining us here in the choir or virtually online. Today is a day when we remember Edward the Confessor, King of England in 1066, and our opening hymn using the green hymn books is hymn 230. The choir will sing Psalm 69 and 70. Please be seated and stand for the Gloria.
Thank you. First reading is from the prophecy of Jeremiah, chapter 14, beginning at the first verse. The word of the Lord that came to Jeremiah concerning the drought. Judah mourns and her gates languish. They lie in gloom on the ground, and the cry of Jerusalem goes up. Her nobles send their servants for water. They come to the cisterns, they find no water, they return with their vessels empty. They are ashamed and dismayed and cover their heads because the ground is cracked. Because there has been no rain on the land, the farmers are dismayed, they cover their heads. Even the doe in the field forsakes her newborn fawn because there is no grass. The wild asses stand on the bare heights, they pant for air like jackals. Their eyes fail because there is no herbage. Although our iniquities testify against us, act, O Lord, for your name's sake. Our apostasies indeed are many, and we have sinned against you. O hope of Israel, its Saviour in time of trouble, why should you be like a stranger in the land, like a traveller turning aside for the night? Why should you be like someone confused, like a mighty warrior who cannot give help? Yet you, O Lord, are in the midst of us, and we are called by your name. Do not forsake us. He ends the Old Testament reading. Reading from Luke's Gospel, chapter 23, beginning at verse 44. It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 PM, while the sun's light failed, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last. When the centurion saw what had taken place, he praised God and said, "Certainly this man was innocent." And when all the crowds who had gathered there for this spectacle saw what had taken place, they returned home beating their breasts. But all his acquaintances, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance watching these things. Now there was a good and righteous man named Joseph, who, though a member of the council, had not agreed to their plan and action. He came from the Jewish town of Arimathea, and he was waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then he took it down, wrapped it in a linen cloth, and laid it in a rock-hewn tomb where no one had ever been laid. It was the day of preparation, and the Sabbath was beginning. The women who had come with him from Galilee followed, and they saw the tomb and how his body was laid. Then they returned and prepared spices and ointments. On the Sabbath they rested, according to the commandment. Here ends the New Testament reading.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
The choir will sing the anthem "Long Since in Egypt's Plenteous Land," music by Hubert Parry.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We pray for our church in this diocese, for the church in Poulton Lancelin, and Reverend Roger Wiles, Reverend Paul Lewis, and Alan Jones, and in the wider Anglican Communion, for the church in Brazil, Amazonia. And in the linked diocese with Congo, we hold before you all refugees and internally displaced persons, numbering in the millions. And we pray for all clergy serving in deprived or violent areas of the world, all who are in personal danger for teaching the faith. May they be reassured and their service blessed by the power of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who serve in positions of authority in this country and throughout the world, for all debates and international talks. And especially we pray for those involved with talks concerning the Middle East and Ukraine. May the power of reason you have given lead us towards your truth and wisdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those we serve each day and those who serve us, for relationships we find difficult, and for situations which tend to make us irritable. Increase our generosity of spirit and our delight in serving others. We pray for the resentful and all who suffer injustice or neglect, for all in need from natural disasters, war, famine, or disease. May your love reach them through our care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our mind. We pray for those who are sick in body or in mind, for Otto Palatai and Carl Ray. In the silence, we bring before God those known to us personally. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who mourn and those who have died, and all who have died in faith, remembering particularly Edna Deleuze, George Stratford, Paul Woodward, Kerry Prendergast, Jean Palatai, Jim Maddox, Charles Bell, and Graham. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We conclude our prayers by saying the grace together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.